Hey Dons,
I'm Emma.
And I'm Matthew.
And welcome back to CCTV.
For those interested in joining Cathedral's cover band, Curbside Service, auditions are happening next week on Wednesday. Check your class Schoology page for more info.
Speaking of music, freshmen, quick reminder that your dance is happening tonight. Come in pajamas and bring your student ID or proof of Schoology and $5. We can't wait to see you for a night of music, treats, and movies. Seniors, makeup picture day for your senior portraits is tomorrow, September 10th. Be sure to make up your photo if you missed your original time.
Also, club applications close today. New and returning clubs must print and fill out the club application and turn it into GC6 by today.
Finally, registrations for AP tests are now open. If you are taking AP classes, check with your teachers for instructions on how to register. Now, let's head over to Sophia, who spoke to Mission and Ministry about Kairos happening next week.
Hey Dons, it's Sophia. I'm here with Ms. Wells and Mr. Grammy with Mission and Ministry. Ms. Wells, what is the Kairos Retreat?
The Kairos Retreat is our senior retreat. It's an overnight retreat up at Palomar. It is one of the best experiences that we offer for seniors. All of our senior graduates will tell you that they had an amazing time on their Kairos Retreat.
Ms. Wells, what activities and opportunities are available for students to help grow their faith at the retreat?
So at retreat, we have senior leaders. So the leaders actually get to walk the students through the retreat. So that's an amazing opportunity as a leader. But then we also, for all of the seniors that are there, we have a lot of really cool talks and discussions and fun games. And we have a lot of time outdoors. So there's a lot of secrets on Kairos. So I can't tell you a lot of the details, but there's many, many ways that the students get to have a great time learning and growing together.
So, Mr. Grammy, what are some of the details about Kairos?
So what seniors need to know is that you can still sign up. We sign up on our website and in Schoology and the resources. It's a 3-day retreat. We do Wednesday from 8 a.m. through Friday at 5 p.m. And make sure you sign up. We have 5 retreats. There's one in September, November, February, March, and April. So check your sports schedules and all the things you do to make sure you're signed up for the right one.
Also, there's wait lists, so if you don't see that there's space immediately, get on a wait list because we completely take a lot of students from the wait list every retreat.
Thank you guys so much.
Run.
Are you ready for homecoming? The moment you've all been waiting for, the 2022 homecoming theme is Pirates. Get yourselves to HOCO on September 24th.
Emma, are you going to wear that to homecoming?
No, although all the decorations will be pirate themed, the dance is semi-formal, so you don't have to come in costume.
Thank goodness. Well, we can't wait to see you all there. Now, let's get to our weekly sports update with Patrick.
What's up, Dons? Welcome back to CCTV Sports. The football team took an L against the 8th-ranked team in the country, Chandler High School, but is looking to bounce back tonight against Helix High School at Helix. The girls' volleyball team killed it up in Hawaii, going 10-0 and winning the tournament on the Big Island, and is looking to continue their streak as they travel up to Orange County this weekend to play tough teams such as Matterday Santa Ana and Lakewood High School. I've heard a lot of good stuff about the girls' golf team. Let's kick it off with Max for more.
What's up, y'all? It's Max. Welcome back to your weekly Cathedral Catholic Television program. I'm here with the girls' golf team. Let's get into it. So, Catherine, with matches lasting up to 2 to 3 hours, how do you stay locked in the whole time?
So, golf is definitely a more of a mental sport. It's really easy to get in your head and let it last throughout the match. But the good thing about golf, you play hole by hole, so it's best as captains to stay positive for our entire team and encourage them to reset as the match goes on.
Brooke, out of all the courses you play in your matches, which one's your favorite?
My favorite's Torrey Pines because the view is beautiful.
Catherine?
I'd say Balboa because it's really challenging, but once you know how to play the course, it's fun.
Who hits the furthest on the team?
Definitely Brooke right here. She is our farthest hitter and she's just so good.
Brooke, out of all the clubs in your bag, which one's your favorite?
Driver because I can hit it pretty far.
Huge shout out to Brooke and Catherine for coming through with the interview. Keep shooting low, ladies, and until next week, Dons.
Thanks, Max. The girls' tennis team is on a roll and is so far 5-0 and play next week versus OOP and Point Loma. The girls' field hockey team is looking unstoppable as they play today against Fallbrook at home. Thank you for tuning in with Sporty Pat, and we'll see you next week.
You ready to go today?
Yes, sir.
Hey, I'll tell you, I was in your guys' shoes. The look in your eyes, I crave that feeling. Where I believe football is the ultimate team sport. You got snot, you got sweat, you got blood. We roll on, no matter what happens. 1, 2, 3,
get some!
Turned down to the 15-yard line and crushed by the middle linebacker, Sean Kagan. Downfield intended for Lucero, who makes a great diving catch. Rayola's looking for a seam down the far side. It's intercepted. The foot is in, and Ty Cortez. Throw the ball to the end zone, and the end zone hauled in by Max Bayless, and the Dons are on the board. Snap back, hold down, kick is through.
Back on social. You know what time it is?
Question of the week.
Let's go. What's your favorite game day theme?
USA.
What's your favorite game day theme?
Probably neon. I would say jerseys.
For sure, blackout.
Neon.
Blackout.
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 White.
I prefer blackout as well.
My favorite game day theme is jersey out.
My favorite game day theme is Hawaiian.
I like the USA theme because I'm very patriotic.
USA.
Yeah, I like the neon theme.
What's your favorite game day theme?
Whiteout.
Definitely neon.
I love the brand new Crush shirts. I wear it every Friday.
I think we should all wear costumes.
Crush!
Thanks, Dons. It was so nice talking to you and hearing about your favorite game day themes.
But in case we missed you, feel free to always go to @DonsNews on Instagram to tell us your info.
Yeah, that's how I got banned from going to homecoming.
Dang, that sucks, dude.
Yo, you guys think I should ask out Lydia?
Ask her out already, man. Stop being a coward.
Trust me, you got this, dude. She's gonna say yes.
All right, I got this.
The cafeteria sells cup of noodles now.
Oh, really?
Yeah, like they did last year, like at the end of the year.
Oh, yeah. Are you gonna eat that?
I was going to. Do you want it?
Oh, yeah. I love, animal crackers.
It's great.
Yeah, the way they, taste and feel.
Please leave.
Come on, the CCTV schedule is like really hard.
Bro, it's killing me, and I mean, all I do is...
Mr. A is like really all over my case because I don't have any skit ideas.
That's because you don't tweet.
Well, hey, I wasn't here yesterday.
I'm the main
character. Oh.
Thanks to our shorts team for that fun clip. As we lead into our home game next week, ASB will be continuing to sell orange shirts for the game. The theme is Don's Crush, so buy your shirt and show up in orange.
Shirts will be sold all next week during break and lunch leading up to the game. We hope you have a great weekend, Dons, and we will see you next week for another episode of CCTV.